Solihull Radio, and I'm joined by Willows, the Veterinary Centre and Referral Service, and we've got some people, and there's some people scurrying behind other people to avoid being seen, but you have been seen, so who have we got here?
My name's Charlotte.
Okay, hello Charlotte.
I'm Jodie. And
Lucy.
And Claire.
And you together are Willows, and we have, well, from a distance, we have my glasses on, I thought there was a very sick dog, but actually no, we've got like a sort of... A stuffed model dog, and you're doing something particularly special with it, aren't you? So what are you doing? Oh, someone else has popped up. Hello, what's your name?
My name is Alessandra.
What name? Alessandra. Where from?
From Italy.
Wow, brilliant.
Working at Willows.
Working at Willows, brilliant. And so what are you teaching us here with this animal?
So, unfortunately, I hope this situation should never happen, but I will teach people how to do CPR if they find their pet diseased.
So CPR for your pet? So can you show me how to do CPR on a dog, and I'll try and describe what's going on Solihull Radio.
Okay.
Should I describe it? Yeah, yeah. Okay. Or
what will happen is before you start CPR, of course, you need to check that your dog is actually passed away. So you will feel for a heartbeat, like Charlotte is doing. You will check if the dog is breathing, and he's not breathing. In that case, you put the dog in lateral recumbency. You look for the highest part of the chest if your dog is a big dog, which is not on the heart, and then you start your chest compressions.
So let's just have a little look. So where were you checking for the heartbeat here?
Yeah.
So we're looking just between the legs here on the front, sort of in the sort of chest sort of area, sort of rib cage, okay. And you're checking to also whether it was breathing?
Yes, that's it.
Okay, so we're going to do chest compression sort of three-quarters of the way between the hind legs and the front legs on the side of the chest. Is that right?
Yes, on the highest point of the chest.
And what sort of ratio of compressions are we doing, or what, or just going for it?
So you should do 100 to 120 compressions a minute, which is very difficult to count. So depending on who you are, you can do it to the rhythm of Macarena, Staying Alive, Nelly the Elephant, or Baby Shark, which I am not very familiar with.
My son loves Baby Shark. He should come here and sing it. Can you do the dance at the same time? Oh, yes! Got renditions of Baby Shark. We'll get it played on Solihull Radio. Zach, come here. Come and do Baby Shark for us. Don't run with a lollipop in your mouth. This is my son, by the way. Can you do Baby Shark? And we're going to try and do CPR to Baby Shark. Okay, ready?
1, 2, 3, go. Baby Shark.
Baby Shark. Baby Shark. Baby Shark. Baby Shark. Oh, sorry. If only it was on TV. It's brilliant. So you just keep doing that. Who would you would? Okay, we'll stop now. It's stop now. It's not real. So what would you do? I mean, presumably you can't phone 999, can you? Who would you phone?
The first thing you absolutely have to do is phone your vet and take the dog to your vet. This is a scenario you would do if you're like in the Scottish Highlands and you have no phone reception and you're on your own, or if you are in the park and you forgot your phone and you are miles away from home, because otherwise you always need to phone your vet and take the dog to the vet, because it's not, unfortunately, like humans that the vet comes to you. You need to bring your patient.
So ideally you need another person to carry on with that in the back of a car or something like that.
I have done that in a car, and I've put a tray underneath the dog to make it harder so that my chest compressions were more effective. And another thing I would like to say, if your dog is not a dog and it's a cat, or it's a very little chihuahua, for example.
Oh, we've got another one.
Yeah.
This is a tiny little kitten.
You wouldn't do chest compressions in the same way.
Of course.
But you would compress directly on the heart. So with your hand, you would go directly on the heart, and you would always use the rhythm of Baby Shark or Macarena or Staying Alive, and you would compress directly on the heart.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Andrew's a diplomat in anaesthesia and analgesia at the Willows, which is one of the highest, well, it is the highest specialism you can achieve as a veterinary surgeon.
So she is a genius.
No.
So how do we find out more? Is this online? Is there guidance online or anything like that, or on the website or something?
No, it is not, because it's something that the vet should do. It is not something we recommend people to do. But of course, if you go home and you find your pet dead, you wouldn't stand there doing nothing, I think. So...
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, everyone. And because of you, I'll have Baby Shark in my head for the rest of the day. Thank you, ladies. Bye now. Well, there we go. That is the first little interview we have on Solihull Radio. And we are going to have a little wonder. Let's have a little look, see what else we can find. We've got Debs. Debs is here. Alex is here. We are live on Solihull Radio. What, have you found anyone interesting?
Yeah, I've been on the stage.
Have you been on stage?
Yeah.
What did you say?
I said all about Solihull Radio.
Genius.
I told them about Solihull Radio.
Let's get your grammar right.
Yeah, let's please.
Correct.
We're on air. Yes. Yeah, I told them about everybody's show all week, and they've asked me to go back in a bit.
How did you do that? Did you give them a sweet or something? Ooh. Alex, have you found anyone?
Well, I saw Debs on the stage, on the main stage. But I've seen, being into colour as I am, I've seen a fantastic colour maze down the bottom there.
Wicked.
That looks really cool.
Are you having a go later?
I might do, yes, yes. That's caught my eye, so I might have a go on that.
I'm a bit too tall for that sort of shenanigans, to be perfectly honest. In a big watery ball? You mean zorbing?
Is that what it is, zorbing?
Yes, it is.
It's a watery ball.
A watery ball is something else. You are listening to us on Solihull Radio here at Fun in the Park. In Solihull, Tudor Grange Park, the sun is out. Who'd have thought that yesterday? So here we go. Okay, and just walking round, we have the mayor at the moment, and I'm going to pass over to Jeff O'Brien, who has got
hello. We meet again. Would you like to say a big hello to Solihull Radio? Let me just introduce you. Councillor Flo Nash is here, walking around, opening the event today. What do you think so far, Flo?
I think it's a fantastic morning, and we really appreciate all the people that have come out in this terrible weather. But I'm sure by this afternoon, everyone will have a great time, and it's all for worthy causes. Thank you.
No problems. We were here very early in the pouring rain this morning. If you are out there listening, Solihull right now, Tudor Grange Park, there's blue sky, and the sun's coming out, and it's hopefully going to be a great day.
Eat and drink as well, so make the effort.
It was lovely seeing you yesterday evening as well at the concert last night. Wasn't it good?
Absolutely fantastic. When all you saw all the talent that was there from young people, it made you very envious to think, you know what, perhaps we didn't have them advantages when we were young.
We're going to get the winner from last night onto the station as well, so should be good fun. Thanks for your time.
Thank you. Look forward to seeing you.
Great stuff. Right, that was Councillor Flo Nash. She is the Mayor of Solihull. And what we're going to do now is we're going to take this microphone, we're going to have a wander round, but just let me know, Nick, if I'm out of range. Right, here we go. We're going to wander down to a lovely display of classic cars just next to the Kids Run, so you can run off some energy if you do want to do that. The first car I'm coming up to, by the looks of it, from my knowledge, is some sort of MG. And then moving down after the MG, let me find out as much as I can about all these wonderful classic cars here in Tudor Grange Park. Today, the sky is blue. I can see contrails from aeroplanes. That's the sort of weather we've got. Oh, in fact, we've got an Austin Healey 3000 Mark III. Absolutely immaculate. Morris Traveller. Again, looking, I don't know how they do this so well, but it looks absolutely brilliant. And Austin Sherborne, and then moving down, we've got some Triumphs, which, you know, a Triumph's amazing. An original Fiat 600, I think, and coming down into a Rolls-Royce Silver Ghost. If you want to come down and see some of these wonderful classic cars, you've just got to come down into Tudor Grange Park today. There's lots of rides, lots of things for the kids to do. Zorbing, a wonderful dog show. We've got a main stage, main arena, so you can come down. We're live. You can come and see us. Why don't you come and see us and get on Solihull Radio today? Hopefully. Nick has just given me the thumbs up, so I've not just been talking to myself down at the bottom of the park here for the last 10 minutes. But we'll have a wander around and see who we can speak to. See who's about. The mayor is still wandering around, seeing all of the oil. They're doing their dog CPR thing. Hello, how are you? Oh, look at this. This is like bumping into people. How's it going so far?
Oh, well, it's all wonderful now. The rain stopped and the sun's out and the sky's blue. Lots of dogs here, all starting to have a wonderful time. So at last, I think fun in the park is well and truly open.
This morning at 8 o'clock when we arrived, it was a completely different story, wasn't it?
It was. It was also a bit wet at 6 o'clock when I arrived.
I don't envy you at all. I don't envy you at all. Listen, we'll keep in touch as the day goes on. And we'll see what's coming up next. What is the first event? So when do the events start?
Well, the dog show start. The first class will now be at 11:30. So any minute now they'll be judging for a dog show. And in the arena we've got activities that run all day. So things going on everywhere, and lots of stalls, of course, lots of children's rides too.
Brilliant. Thank you very much for your time, because you're probably rushing around everywhere now, aren't you? Thanks for that. Organiser, if you are around Tudor Grange, like I say, definitely come down and see as many people as you can here in Tudor Grange Park. Loads of things for people to do. Who are an amazing sort of soft play area for the kids as well. Dog agility, foods. Oh, pancakes. Lovely. Listen, I'm rambling. I'm going to head back, speak to Nick, and we'll play you a little bit of music, and then I'll find out who's going to be the winner of this first. See, that's children enjoying themselves. Going to see who the winner is going to be of the first judged dog show competition today in a lovely arena here in Tudor Grange. If you do come down to Tudor Grange, you can't miss us. We're right up in the cycling area at the top of the park. Here's Nick.
Thank you very much, Jeff. Thanks for being our roving reporter there. I'm going to pop out. We'll all be here, popping out and chatting to some people in a bit here at Fun in the Park. But here, for your delectation, we have some music with George Jackson. Good morning. We are live on Solihull Radio. We're just having a little wander around. I have a little chat to some people. I'm Nick Whitehouse. And we've got the NCT here. Look at that. It's interesting there. Snowy cones. Oh, look at that. There's some dogs having... You can take your dog on an assault course. And there's just a little poodle there, I think. Just about to be tempted to go through a little tube in the ground and totally ignoring its owner. There we go. That sounds like my kind of training. Oh, look at this. Platinum pancakes. I wonder if they can still hear me. Jeff, you got the thumbs up? Yes, we have. I'm going to go down here. There we go, wandering around towards the main stage. Of course, your premier entertainment provider should be Solihull Radio. There we go, you can see them in the background. Let's go and have a chat to this lady here with some balloons. Hello there. I'm live on Solihull Radio and with Explore Learning. To say hi, tell us about what you're doing at the moment.
Hi everyone, we're from Explore Learning and we are here to talk about maths and English tuition.
So, where are you?
So we're based on Stratford Road in Shirley.
Okay, and who are you aiming this towards? Or adults or both?
So we're aiming this towards children between the ages of 4 to 14, and we offer lots of interesting courses like 11 plus tuition, which is our most favourite one. We've got CIS, we've got creative writing, creative maths, so we do lots of different things for different kind of interests.
There we go. Okay, well, the range of the wireless is making us a little bit crackly, so I have to step back in just a moment. But so are you primarily just sort of giving people from just improving their English in terms of examinations, or if someone's just new to the country and you can help them learn an English as a brand new language?
To be honest, we follow the national curriculum, and what we are, what we do in our centre is we try to create fearless learners. So our aim really is to give kids the independence and the courage to learn maths and English tuition. So that's really.
So you're helping people to thrive at school if they're a little bit. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. It's a pleasure. Thank you very much. Okay, I'm going to head a little bit further in back into range now and see what we've got here. So we've got Stagecoach. Ooh, let's have a little chat to Stagecoach. Is there anyone from Stagecoach who'd like to talk to Solihull Radio? Do you want to come and talk to Solihull Radio? Come on, over here. Here we go. So who have we got here?
My name's Abby Stokes.
Abby Stokes, and how old are you?
I'm
You're 12, and who have I got here?
My name's Chloe Lane.
And how old are you?
I'm 13.
And have you been in stage... Oh, I've got other people here. It'd be unfair if I didn't say... They're turning up the main stage because they can say, I'm here, obviously.
And she's not coming to talk about herself.
What's your name?
Imogen.
Imogen. And how old are you?
Evan.
Okay. And who have I got here?
Emily.
And how old are you, Emily?
11.
Well, all similar. Are you all in the same class?
I'm Saturday afternoon.
And what about you?
Saturday morning.
Okay, and what sort of things do you do at Stagecoach?
It helps us build our confidence, and it helps us with our future and what we want in our career.
And what would you like to do?
I'd like to be an actor and in like West End theatre.
And would you all like to do the same thing?
I'd like to be a singer.
What sort of singing do you do?
I don't know, really. I just like singing.
A bit of everything. An all-rounder. What about you guys? What do you want to do in the future?
I want to be an actor and a singer. I just want to be an all-round performer.
I like that. Jack of all trades. Very versatile. So do you do those things at Stagecoach?
Yeah, it just helps you. And I've only been there for about a year, and I feel like I've gained more confidence and more skill in everything I want to do.
Okay, and you're here all day. And where is Stagecoach? How do we find out more about them if we want to? Who's going to tell me that?
You just get some leaflets on the board.
Okay, and tell me some key numbers and websites.
Just to let you know, on the hour.
So the number there is at the bottom. Who's going to tell me the number?
0121 745 4007.
Brilliant. We've also got a website here.
Stagecoach.co.uk/Solihull.
Fantastic. Thank you, girls. Enjoy the day. Fantastic. So walking across here, we've got the Soroptimists. We've also got Tomorrow's Engineers there. We might have a chat to them in a bit. And we're coming back. We've got Standart. I like a bit of Standart. That's good. I'm going to head back. I think it's time for a bit of music before I head out and have a chat to more people in a bit. I'm just walking around the back of the studio, and I should see when just around the corner, Mr. Jeff O'Brien. I'm going to say, hit me with some music.
Right, I'm hoping, ladies and gents, that Alex is out there in the field, as they say. So, is Alex around? Has anyone seen Alex? If you are...
So I've got Charlotte from Dansburg here. Dansburg, should I say. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
I'm very well. Are you having fun here today?
Yeah, it's brilliant. We're hoping just for a little bit more turnout later on now the sunshine's come out.
Okay. And is it just you here today, or are there other people from Dansburgs here?
Yeah, so we were at the Bugs group, actually, and we have Dansburgs here, we have Yoga Bugs, and we have Footy Bugs here today.
Cool. And how often do you run these classes, and where could we go if we want to join in with Footy Bugs or Dansburgs?
Brilliant. So the Bugs group are located in Solihull and Birmingham areas, and we run classes on weeknights and weekdays, and as well as in lots of schools around the local area.
Okay, well, it sounds really fantastic, and if we want to get in contact with you, have you got a website or an email address?
Yep, so we've got, if you visit thebugsgroup.com, or you can give us a call on 0121 777 7792, and we offer free taster sessions for everyone's first class.
Okay, well, that's fantastic, and we hope you have a great day here.
Brilliant, Angie. Thank you.
Thank you.
I tell you what, wasn't that the best person ever to do some advertising for? Whoever that was, Alex, absolutely brilliant. She's got a great radio voice. So, Alex, if he's out and about, he'll find some more people. But for now, here's a little bit more music for you.
Okay. Hi, Deb's Donnelly here, Solihull Radio. I'm at the fun in the park.
I'm here with Lorraine Hart from Solihull Age UK. How are you doing? Are you having fun today?
Yes, it's a bonus with the weather. It's all brightening up now. It certainly wasn't the case at 8 o'clock this morning, but no, it's looking good for a great day here at the park.
Yes, no, I thought the weather this morning would be a little bit iffy, but no, it's turned out really nice. And so what have you got? A load of lollipops here, I can see. What's that all about with the lollipops?
Well, we're running a pick a lolly stall. This is in Age UK Solihull to try and raise a little bit of money for us to help us help older people in the borough. So the stall is you come and pay your 50p and you choose a lolly. And if you choose one with blue on the bottom, then you come and win a prize from our table at the back here. We've had prizes donated by Tiger and also by the entertainer in Solihull as well. So shout out to them to say thank you. If it's black on the bottom, they get the 50p back. And if there's nothing on the bottom, they still win a lolly to lick. So everybody's a winner.
Well, that sounds absolutely fantastic. So if you're passing the Age UK stall, it's just by the sand art and near the main stage, then come down and pick a lolly and, you know, you won't be disappointed. You might win a prize even with that. And if we wanted to get in contact with Age UK, have you got a website or an email address or anything like that?
Yeah, people can go to www.ageuksolihull.org.uk.
Okay, well, that's thank you very much and appreciate you coming on our radio today. Thank you.
Hi, it's Deb Stanley here, Solihull Radio. We're actually at Fun in the Park at Tudor Grange. If you'd like to join us, please come along. It's on between 11 and 5. I've been around various stands tempting people with my chockies with Jeff's daughter, Maddie. And we've had a go on the pole dancing. We've been and stroked a few dogs that are here. There's quite a few dogs here, actually. We've spoken to people on the guide dogs for the blind. And around the corner, Alex has just come. Like, he was surprised. He's a little surprised look on that face there. So, if you're not doing anything, the sun is coming out. Excuse me. The rain has stopped, and we are actually at Tudor Grange Park for Fun in the Park. It's on till 5, and hopefully the rain will hold off. Maddie, tell us what you think of it so far.
It's great.
See, there you said it from the horse's mouth. It's great. Alex, what do you think?
It's fantastic, isn't it, Debs?
It is. It's been a fantastic day so far, and we've only been here an hour, so heaven knows what it'll be like later. Anyway, I'll put you back on to some music, if you like. Hold on.
Hello, everyone. I'm here with Will, who's got some gorgeous dogs. Are you having fun today?
Yeah, it's great fun. Really enjoying it. The dogs are loving being out and about.
And have you come to bring your dogs to the agility course or anything like that?
I think we'll give them a go on the agility course.
How do you think your dogs will do today?
I think Olive might do better than Rocket. Rocket's a bit of a wild card.
So you've got two dogs, Olive and Rocket.
Olive's a year older than Rocket. They're working Cocker Spaniels and they're absolutely crazy.
They look absolutely gorgeous. Have you travelled far to come here today?
No, we live in Shirley, so not too far today.
Oh, that's good. So hopefully you'll have a fantastic time and maybe we'll see you again later?
Yeah, exactly. See you later.
Thank you. That was great. Thank you.
Right, if you're listening in to Solihull Radio this afternoon, I have got an amazing guest for us. A little while earlier, Nick was out and about, and some people have come up to see me today, and I am joined in our outside broadcast studio here at Fun in the Park by Darshan. Darshan, where are you from?
I'm from Solihull.
You're local?
Yes, I've been in Solihull for the last 25 years.
Fantastic. And why are you at Fun in the Park today?
I'm here to promote the maths and English tuition services that we're offering through Solihull Colleges. We are a first-class learning company, a franchise, a very successful franchise that is throughout the UK and expanding. We now have 280 centres, and we saw the opportunity to bring the services here to Solihull. And so we're hoping to help the children in our area and borough to reach those top spots and become future leaders of this country, hopefully.
Absolutely. And there's some absolutely fantastic people, young people, coming through the college and school system in Solihull, isn't there?
Absolutely. My children were all schooled here locally, a bit at Rookley, but they've now gone on to successful degrees, medicine, history, geography, so they're all moving ahead with their lives, and I want to put some of that back into the children who are not so fortunate to be able to go to the top schools.
Okay, so your maths and English tuition, whereabouts are you based? You're based at Solihull College, you say? But a slight technical hitch there. If you were around and listening to what we were doing, Darshan is here, and we were just asking him some questions about the courses and the things that you're offering. Is it at Solihull College?
Yes, we're based in Solihull College. Saturday mornings from 10 o'clock till 12 o'clock, and we are offering maths and English tuitions on an individual-based program. So we can assess the children in terms of their current level of capability, and we promote them step by step throughout their maths and English journeys. But the beauty of it is that this program from First Class Learning is actually developed in line with the national curriculum. There are very few other tuition services out there that can say that the material has been developed from the ground up with the national curriculum in mind. So it's developed by the same people that set the exams, that sit on the exam boards. And so it is very closely aligned system to the national curriculum. And that's why a lot of schools actually like the system that first class learning are offering. So, yeah, I'm hoping to help the children in this borough as much as possible, really.
Okay, so first class learning, how do we get in touch with you? Where do we find out all about where to go?
Yeah, we have a central website, firstclasslearning.co.uk/Solihull, and that brings you straight to the webpage for the Solihull Centre. On the parent site, you will find a centre throughout the country. We are, like I said before, we are very successful. We have up to 280 centres around the country, so that's a demonstration of how well the system works. And we are the first in this area now, so we are hoping to promote the first class tuition service in this area.
Brilliant. Thanks, Darshan. Thanks for coming in and seeing us today.
Pleasure.
And hopefully we'll see you around Fun in the Park.
Yes, will do. Thank you.
Thanks. Right, listen in if you would like. We've got a little bit more music. We did have a bit of a technical hitch with our shelter here. The wind just took it, but it's looks like it's been repaired. So join us again in a minute.
Right, here on Solihull Radio, and I'm joined by the very lovely...
Margot.
This is Margaret, and we've got a dog here. What sort of dog is this?
It's a Cardiganshire Corgi.
And what's the Corgi's name?
Megan.
Hello, Megan. Now, you've got a fantastic story you were telling me about your husband, is that right?
My husband, he was a standard bearer for Britain, and he led the cenotaph carrying the Union Jack at the start. He opened Coventry Cathedral with a standard. He was a standard bearer. He's actually was in the Burma Star, so he fought in Burma with the South African Brigade. He was also at Dunkirk. He died about 4 years ago, but he was 96, you know. So that's why SAFRA have always been very supportive. They're brilliant. They look after everybody, not just the people in need, you know.
So does SSAFA do a similar thing to like the British Legion might or something like that?
Yes, they're part of it. They're all part of the group of charities covering, you know, any army, whatever. But I find them marvellous. If I want to, if I have a problem, I can't find a gardener, they would find me a gardener, you know. So they support, not just when you're in trouble. They're absolutely great.
So I should definitely go and have a little chat to them in their tent just across the way.
Very much so. They're here and they do a great job for my husband. Obviously, he would have been 100 now, but they still care for me. And I think they're wonderful. You should definitely have a chat to them.
I shall make sure we go and do that personally. I think it's a wonderful cause, and thank you very much for coming. Did you win today? Has your dog been involved?
I expect to win today, but we have to expect to win today, don't we?
Yeah, you have to. You have to go in there. You've got to have confidence. Thank you very much for your time. I really appreciate it, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the day. Thank you. Okay, so let's have some more music here on Song.
Hi, Deb Stonnen here, Solihull Radio. I'm now talking to Adrian, who runs Kids Run Free. Would you like to tell us about your company?
Yeah, so we're a charity, national charity, registered with the Charity Commission. But locally in Solihull, we hold regular running races for kids of all ages, from toddlers through to 16 years of age. Any running ability is welcome. And we've got events in Bentley Heath Park, Alton Park, in Alton Jubilee Park. And we meet at Alton every second and fourth Saturday of the month. And it's there just to try and promote that focus on well-being and fitness in young kids, and try and drag them away from games, consoles, and all of that stuff. It's completely free of charge for parents, and we tend to have our events at 9 o'clock in the morning. You're there for an hour, get away. The kids have loads of fun. And we're promoting that physical well-being over time with them as well.
Okay, that's wonderful. So, if you are worried about your children just sitting there and just vegetating, which is basically what this generation does, isn't it? You need to get on to Adrian, and he, I'm going to take a leaflet out of his sweaty little paw right now, and we're going to put it on our notice board at the studio, and we will promote it for you on, oh, well, I will promote it for you on my show, if that's okay.
That's fine.
Right, thank you, Adrian, for popping in to our wonderful gazebo here. And I'll let you carry on with your deliveries, dear.
Thank
you very much. Bye.
We are here at Solihull Radio, here live in Fun in the Park. And I'm going to have a little wander over and I'm going to have a chat to, I think, we've got some police community support officers. I might say hi. Let's go over here. Hello, Alessandro. Alessandra. Sorry, forgive me. I just made her into a man there. I do apologise. Okay, so we've got the Bowman Dogs home. Who have we got over here? This is Maddie's Vegetarian Dog Treats. Hello, and I'm speaking to... Is you Maddie by any chance?
No, I'm Kate. Maddie's the dog.
Oh, Maddie's the dog. How clever is Maddie having her own business? Hello, Maddie. Hello. Say woof. Say woof for Solihull Radio.
Speak.
Good dog. Good dog. All right. I've now caused a scene and Maddie is wrecking her own shop. Right, so what have we got here? Tell us all on Solihull Radio.
These are all healthy, handmade dog treats we make at home. They're all made of ethical ingredients, organic, free-range eggs, etc., all inspired by Maddie.
Wow, and what sort of brought, just by having Maddie, you decided you were going to launch it, or has Maddie got a particular health need that she needs to be healthy?
No, we rescued Maddie 2 years ago. She had a few issues when we first had her, and we wanted to make sure that she was eating healthy dog treats with no artificial preservatives or additives. But we couldn't find anything like that on the market, so we decided to start making our own.
That's a fabulous history. So if people want to find out a bit more, there's a website here. It's www.maddiesdogtreats.co.uk. Price is starting from £2. Have you got a special offer on today? If someone listening wants to come down? Or...
Yeah, we have any 12 pick-a-mix treats for £2. We also have bandanas, 2 for £1.50. So just come down and have a little...
Is that a bandana for a person or a dog?
For a dog.
Okay, I was just making sure of that. Okay, well, that's fantastic. Thank you very much. Who else have we got here? This must be...
I'm Steve. I'm just helping.
Steve, who's just helping. Maddie is now sulking. Now she's a star on the radio. She's sort of facing the other way. And who have we got here?
I'm Jet.
And you are the personal assistant to Maddie. I can obviously see it. So that's fantastic. Thank you very much. You'll probably find that you will be on solihullradio.com. You are live at the moment, but you'll probably be on a podcast soon. So do check us out there and you'll hear about Maddie's Treats. Thank you very much. So we are joined together here, Jeff and I, chatting away at the Solihull Radio marquee, I was going to say there. It's more of a gazebo. Looking out over the dog display, we've got the dog section here. We've got a mini golf putting green to the right, the information hub to the left. Jeff, it's been a great morning so far, hasn't it?
So far, it absolutely has. Bearing in mind that we started setting this up in the pouring rain this morning here in Tudor Grange Park, if you do want to come down to Tudor Grange Park, by all means, find us up here on the cycle area.
We've got sweets.
We do have sweets.
Our kids stop eating them,
yeah,
that is.
And the biscuits are going very quickly, I've noticed as well. The weather is a little bit overcast, but there's no rain. And if you are dog lovers, we are directly opposite the main arena stand here. And there's some amazing dogs taking part in...
Do you know what, mate, which is particularly good, is I love the classic cars. Just a bit further down from the right from our marquee, I keep saying gazebo, studio, we should say.
Yeah, there's
some beautiful, beautiful classic cars. You wandered down there a bit earlier, didn't you? What did you see?
There's an amazing Austin Healey 3000 Mark III. If anyone out there like me knows what an Austin Healey Mark III 3000 is, it is in immaculate condition. Right next to the Austin Healey, you've got a Morris Traveller with the wood in fantastic condition as well. Moving a little bit further forward, you've got a Triumph Dolomite Sprite, and then I think it is a Rolls-Royce Silver Ghost.
Do you know what I fancy? I like the Triumph Stag.
The Triumph Stag.
I like a stag.
It's time to get the stag. And listen, there's some
Let's
amazing cars.
Let's get the stag out of the garage.
Yeah. There's some amazing cars. And if you do come, as you come through the main door, you will see a bus on the side. And that bus is reputedly the bus used in the Italian Job.
That is, I was wondering around there how many people are going to stand there and do a Michael Caine impression. Yeah.
You're only supposed to blow the door.
Yeah, exactly.
Off.
Yeah. Well, I'm just going to have a little chat, if you don't mind, to this lady here who is just modelling some balloons at the moment. Hi there, Nick Whitehouse from Solihull Radio. How are you? What are you doing here today?
I'm doing balloon modelling.
You're from Magic Party, that's right. Are you wandering around doing some balloon modelling? What are you modelling right now, just for us, with your silver balloon?
Silver Sword for Zach.
Okay, and you have a repertoire, I presume, of different things that you can do. What's probably the hardest thing that you could do? Making a big decision here.
Well, I don't just make small balloons, I make very big balloons. So probably the hardest one has probably been the 8-foot dragon that I made.
An 8-foot dragon? Well, that's a big balloon. How long does it take to make that big 8-foot dragon?
Near enough 4 hours.
Wow. And what do you sort of make that for, a party occasion or something like that?
I make balloons for all occasions, sort of birthday parties, or we come out and do balloon modelling fates and things. We do weddings, we do all sorts of things.
Fantastic. If we wanted to find out a bit more about Magic Party, have you got a website or anything like that?
Yes, we have. It's www.magicparty.co.uk.
Thank you very much. It was a pleasure talking to you. Thank you very much.
You see, these are the sort of people that we are bumping into today here at Fun in the Park, which, as you know now, is in Tudor Grange. There's quite a lot of people here, actually. It's beginning to get busy.
It is starting to get a bit busier, and massive relief after we saw the storm clouds yesterday. It was touch and go whether it was actually going to happen. But look at that. We've got blue sky, a lovely cool breeze, some great entertainment, and a wonderful day for charity. Absolutely. That's the most important thing. They're raising money for a whole range of charities supported by the Sir Optimists.
And also supported by the St. Alfred's Rotary. So between the pair of them, they've done an amazing job yet again. There's some amazing organisers here. And like I say, if you fancy coming down this afternoon, you'll have a lovely time. I think the object of this game is to get that golf ball onto that tiny piece of paper.
I believe that tiny piece of paper is a £5 note, Jeff.
Right.
Well, and if you get it, I think you might get the fiver.
Right, I understand now. Bearing in mind, I haven't got my glasses on, and it's a little bit away from me. Look at that.
Here we go. We have the lovely... Oh, we have a dog with a rosette. Let's talk to the man, or the boy, with a dog with a rosette. Hey, excuse me, can you have a chat just on Solihull Radio, please? What's your name?
Max.
Okay, Max is going, don't talk to me on the radio. What's the name of your doggy? Sunny? Okay, I'm really pleased he's won fifth place. So we've got some other dogs over here. What are these names of these dogs? Sorry, your name first, please.
Hello, my name's Fee.
Hi, Fee. And who have we got here? What sort of dogs?
Romanian rescue dogs, and it's Joy and Hope.
And are they entering into the competition today, or have they already done so?
They're just about to enter into the prettiest girl competition.
And they're going to win, easily.
Look at that smile. Who could resist that?
I couldn't, that's for sure. She would have me seduced, no end.
Exactly. So they're a bit of this and a bit of that, but we think they're beautiful.
Great. Are you going to have a go on the dog agility as well?
Yeah, sure. Why not?
Yeah, let me know how you get on. You. See you later. So back to base.
Back to base. Look at these.
We have a balloon model dog as well.
Evie, turn around. Look at those lovely dogs.
Wow. Yeah. We have dog after dog after dog.
This is the place to come if you've got some dogs to walk today.
If you're into that, that is perfect for you.
There's some good stuff. We'll go back to some music. See you in a bit. Right then, we are still here at Fun in the Park in Tudor Grange. So if you are in central Solihull in the town centre today, why don't you wander down the slope by John Lewis and come up to the cycling track here in Tudor Grange and see us all. We're all enjoying ourselves here. The rain has stopped. The sun is out. And there's lots and lots of people just milling around, having lots of dogs. Like Nick said, if you like dog shows and seeing people with lots of the canines, you should definitely come up to Tudor Grange today. Alex, if you listen to Alex's show this morning, thank you very much for doing that. Alex is here. Alex, how do you think the day's going?
It's going really well. It's the second time I've done the radio today, so I'm sort of a bit of a radio expert today, I guess.
You are, aren't you? It's we're getting there now. And Nick's gone for a wander. Do you remember the £5 note mini golf?
Yes.
Thing.
Nick, it looks quite difficult, actually.
Nick has been cajoled into
having a go,
into letting his children have a go, and that could possibly. Oh, Maddie's having a go now. Here we go.
Right,
if this works, I'll be absolutely amazed. But on the radio, this is a great thing to be talking about. People doing mini golf right next to where we are here on in front of the park. I tell you what. Oh, that's a shame. That's a shame.
Nearly.
Nearly. I think we've got a little bit of music coming up. And don't forget, we've got Lee's live show from our Touchwood studio starting at 4 o'clock this afternoon. She's got some amazing guests. Have a look at the website. Have a look at what's going on. And we'll speak to you, hopefully, very soon.
Hello, everyone. I'm joined here with children's author R.B. Maxwell. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
And I can see you've got a book there that you've brought with you. It's called The Invisible Agent. Can you tell me a bit more about what the book's all about?
Okay. The book is for 9 to 11, 9 to 12-year-olds. It's a science fantasy action-adventure superhero novel. It's basically about a teenage super spy that races against the clock that has to stop a top international criminal from taking things over and also guaranteeing his own survival, because there's twists and turns completely throughout the story. So, yeah, and it also ends on a cliffhanger.
Wow, that sounds a really, really interesting book. I mean, what inspired you to start writing that kind of book?
It started, I suppose, from when I used to take my daughter to school. We used to play superheroes going to school. So we used to role play all the time. So I think the initial idea came from that. And it's just grown from that, really.
And what other kind of books have you written about already? Or is that your first one?
That's my first one that's published. It came out on May the 28th and we sold nearly 300 copies. And the publishers also sold e-books as well.
Wow, have you got any... I mean, it looks like a fantastic book. I'd love to have a read. Have you got any plans to write any more books?
I'm about three quarters of the way through my second novel at the moment, with the same characters.
Yeah, I mean, like I said, it's fantastic that you've written your own book, and you'll have to, you know, come on my show and tell me more about it, or on my children's show. If we want to buy a copy, what's the best way of getting hold of one?
The best way of getting at the moment is to go to our website, which is www.theinvisibleagent.com. And there's a button there that takes you directly to the publisher, so you can get it either in paperback format or in any other e-back format, including Apple, Google Books, on Amazon, wherever you want to get it. It's also available on the Waterstones websites and a lot of the other websites as well.
And how much does it cost if we want to go and buy one?
It's £8.99 if you want to buy one. If you want to buy one today, it's even more exciting because it's £8 today. It's also personalised. It's signed by myself, and also I have my, I'll show you, I have a photo gallery of kids. Just ignore that a moment. And I brought with me my superhero character called Max, who is the character in the book, and they can actually have a photograph taken with Max and put onto the social media galleries that we have. So let me show you, there we are, that's it. And it's just loading. And there's Max.
Wow, that's Max. Wow, that's fantastic. And where is he based today? Is he here?
I'm based here today. So if you want a photo taken with Max, you want the book that's signed, and you want it at a special price, you can get it today here at the event.
Okay, well, it's definitely a book that I would urge everyone to go and read. So if you go around and try and find R.B. Maxwell and her book, The Invisible Agent, then she's up near the main stage. So I urge you all to go down and have a look and buy one of her books. They look really, really fantastic. Thank you for coming on today.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Okay, hi. It's Deb Donnelly, Solihull Radio, Saturday night presenter, I'd like to say. And we're just speaking to...
Grace Hampson,
and she's going to tell us about Fun in the Park and the charities that get involved with it, if that's okay.
Okay. Yes, thank you. Fun in the Park now, we've been going 12 years, and each year we support three local charities. This year we're supporting the Lily May Foundation, which is based in Balsall Common, Solihull Mind Horticultural Project, which is based in Knowle, that's for people with mental health problems, and the third one is St Basil's, which is for homeless young people, an emergency accommodation service that we're funding. So three excellent causes.
I've never been here before. I'm not going to lie. Do you feel it's doing well? I'm just glad the sun's come out, do you? and the weather's turned.
The sun's now shining, so people are coming out and about. We've got lots of dogs in our wonderful dog show, lots of children's rides, a fabulous arena. Obviously, the few days before, we were very worried that it might not go ahead, but here we are. It's up and running, and we're really delighted to see people coming and supporting us.
Okay, well, thank you very much for your words. And I shall go and wander now with my big pink microphone. Thank you very much. Thank you. Oh, yes, it goes with your coat. Thank you. Right, bye, Alex. We're back on to music.
Refuse from a silver vow, put her faith into the moon and stars. Said she had a mind that slept inside tomorrow, and time could only heal its scars. She was fire on the border. Line.
It's just something to say. Going round inside my head. I'm gonna save my soul before things get impossible. I should have seen the signs, and they were right before my eyes. You could have saved my soul. I fall alone across the bay. I think I saw.
Solihull Radio yet again. You'll be sick of my voice by then. I'm now speaking to Chris because we actually got somebody to talk to us about SAFA. Could you tell us what SAFA is and what's involved with it?
I can certainly do that. SAFA itself, the acronym stands for Soldier, Sailor, Airmen, Families Association. But we are the Armed Forces Charity. And we've been in business since 1885, helping service people, ex-service people and their families. When they are in need, they ring us up and they say, I need whatever it is. If it is advice, we will try to advise. If it is something where they need expert help, then we will signpost. And if it's something more practical, then we'll try and raise the funds to meet a practical need.
Oh, excellent. Right, okay. So, we are actually opposite. We're actually opposite. I thought it was saying you want a drink. Yeah, have a cup of tea, please.
We'll always have a cup of tea.
Yeah, of course. A cup of tea's on. Will you stop doing that, please? Thank you. Right, okay. So now, we're actually opposite the SAFA stand. Are you doing very well today? Are you doing okay?
Well, I do hope so. I've got a number of people on the stand who are volunteers with the organisation. I'm here as a seroptimist today, but I wear double hat. As a seroptimist, we're the organisers of Fun in the Park.
So I've got,
absolutely, two hats here. We've got people who've been coming up and talking about what we do. I've got people who actually are in need who have come to say, hello, I need something. And so we're giving them our phone number because we have an office locally. So give them our phone number and say, give me a call or leave a message and we'll get back to you. And others who just want to know what we're in the business of doing and offer their support.
Right, so come along to Tudor Grange Park today, speak to Chris, go to the SAFA stand, purchase a T-shirt and anything else that is available on there.
Oh, we've got these wonderful little bracelets, like little charm bracelets.
Yeah, I'm coming over across. How much are they?
They're only £5.
Oh, are they? I might come and have a look because I quite like them.
They're brilliant.
Yes, I'm coming now.
Good show. Come with me.
Tally-ho. Thank you, Chris. Lovely to speak to you. Right, okay. Thank you, Nick. Back.
Point. By the fantastic Emily here at Solihull Radio at Fun in the Park. How on earth are you?
I'm fantastic. Thank you so much for asking. I was very sad when I woke up this morning and saw that it was so overcast and so much rain. And now, wow, the sun has come out and what a delightful day everybody is having here.
Absolutely. It's a little bit windy, don't get me wrong.
Yeah, a little bit windy, but you know, you win some, you lose some.
In the great scheme of things, it's not raining.
And there are so many dogs here, so many beautiful dogs. Small dogs, big dogs,
yeah,
fluffy
everything.
Dogs, shiny dogs.
The next big show, actually, is coming up in a few minutes' time.
And what's that, Jeff?
I think it's medium-sized dogs.
Medium-sized dogs. So arguably my favourite. Oh, no. This is not good for radio, but I've just poured pizza all over the floor.
Medium-sized
dogs are fantastic dogs.
Here comes
so
the wind.
For that show.
I shall hold on to the gazebo.
Hold on to the gazebo so we don't blow away.
It did earlier today.
Oh, did it?
Yeah,
wow.
It ended up over there.
How exciting.
Directly behind us.
It's good advertising, though, isn't it? Everyone saw that, I bet.
Yep, absolutely.
how are you doing, Jeff?
We're doing all right, yeah. Setting up at 8 o'clock this morning was tricky in the rain.
Was it still raining at that point?
It was. It was absolutely horrid.
Disappointing. But now, check it out. We've got blue skies.
That's right. Go out there and talk to some people.
Have you sampled any delicious foods or beverages?
Foods. I've had a stone-baked pizza from the pizza oven just down
Incredible.
The way from us. Amazing that was. Here comes the wind again.
Awesome.
Other than that, it's been very good. There's been a steady flow of people.
Lovely. Yeah, I'm really glad people have still come out despite it being a bit horrendously windy, but not horrendously windy, perfectly windy. I love wind.
Yeah.
Who doesn't love wind?
No, it's quite good.
Really?
It's quite good. Listen, if you are listening in and you've got some time this afternoon, why don't you come down to Tudor Grange Park? Come up to the cycling track, which is just at the top of the park there. and come and join in Fun in the Park.
Woohoo! I'm having so much fun. How much fun are you having?
An amazing amount now. Immeasurable.
Ah, too much to even handle.
So, it's definitely worthwhile. And like you say, we're here until 5 o'clock this afternoon, but the show will stop broadcasting around... just before 4 o'clock, because Lee is over in our Touchwood studio.
She is indeed. I actually just left her, and she's rolling over there right now, ready to go.
Right.
It's going to be a fantastic show she's got today, so everyone click into that also.
Everyone, if you're listening to our outside broadcast here, why don't you stay connected at 4 till 6 this evening with the fantastic Lee Perry here on Solihull Radio. Like I say, though, she's in the warm in the studio over in Touchwood, which we can see, I suspect, if we look up the hill.
Check that out.
We can see where the Touchwood studios are, so we're not far away.
Yeah, come down to Fun and Park and come and say hi to us. We've got lots of chocolate and candy and good times to be had here, so please come down. It's a great day. It just come for the dogs, if nothing else. It's just such good times.
I imagined that I could comfort you. I had forgotten the things that you've been through. But here's one thing on which we can agree. When you're ready, darling, you can lean on me. And the love I bring will grow into a lasting thing. It'll put your heart on wings and set you free. And as you rise high into the clearing skies, maybe you'll realize that you can lean on me. Cause lean on me, baby, lean on me. Yeah, you can lean on me, honey, lean on me. Heartaches are hidden deep inside, so there's no telling how many tears you've cried. But like the river to the weeping willow tree, I can hold your teardrops, child, just lean on me. A sweet loving care, and girl, I'll find the strength, I swear. And when you need me, I'll be there. Yeah. If you let it be, till time is done, and the longest race is run.
I must apologise if you are listening to the live output from Solihull Radio. We can't actually see some of the music that we're playing this afternoon, so it might be slightly different to the music that you are normally listening to from our output, but thank you very much for joining us. We are live, broadcasting live from Fun in the Park in Tudor Grange. Amazing afternoon here in central Solihull. My name is Jeff O'Brien. Joining me here are lots of presenters and lots of people from the station. We've got Nick Whitehouse, we've got Alex Manners, we've got Debs Donnelly, Emily, our amazing social media PR captain, is here as well. So if you want to come down and see us, why don't you say I was listening earlier and we thought we'd come down and see you. We're right next to the main arena for the dog show. We're right opposite that, so you can't really miss us. And they're waiting for the next dog show to begin, or the next round of the dog show to begin. So why don't you come down? Weather, a bit blustery, don't get me wrong. It's quite cold, so definitely put a coat on. Yeah, help yourselves. Help yourselves to biscuits. Help yourselves to sweets. Let me go and talk to these people. Hi. What's your name? Say again. No, whoever. Kristen. Tristan. Tristan, would you like to say hello to everybody on Solihull Radio? Oh, would you like a sweet? You could have some sweets. You could have a biscuit. Why don't you have a biscuit while you're wandering around? What's your favourite biscuit? Favourite biscuit? No. Oh, he's going for it. Enjoy. Oh, look. Bye-bye. See you later. There's some lovely people. We're basically giving away biscuits and sweets here at Solihull Radio. So if you walk past us and don't take one of our sweets or a biscuit, we'll be disappointed. But you're more than welcome to come up and be a guest here on Solihull Radio. If you want to have a chat live on air, why don't you join us? Let me just have a look, actually, and see what I can see on here. If you just bear with me for half a second. Let's see what's going on. We have got quite a lot of things happening. Let me just see who's currently logged in. Oh, somebody in Solihull. Why don't you come down? If you are in Solihull and you're currently listening to the output of Solihull Radio, why don't you come down and see us? It should be good fun. Let me just play that, go into that. That's happening there. Here's some music for you. Chris Christopherson. Can't go wrong with that. Here you go. I'll tell you what's really funny. If you are just listening to the output of Solihull Radio, we're here live in the park, Fun in the Park, in Tudor Grange, but there are Zorbs. If you're not familiar with a Zorb, it's basically a massive inflatable ball that you get into and sort of wander around in and bump into things, but there are human Zorbs, which I'm just looking at now, and it's quite funny in the wind, to be honest. If you could imagine a massive inflatable ball that's being... It's like being in a hamster ball. If you imagine what that looks like, and the wind blowing all these people around the cycle tracks of Tudor Grange Park. So if you want to come and join in and have a look at these people being blown around in the inflatable hamster balls, by all means do. And here's a bit more of Chris Christopherson. But I just thought I'd let you know about that.
Hi, it's me, Nick, here at Fun in the Park. And I am lucky enough to be joined by Phil in a very small gazebo. He's just bumped his head. Are you okay?
Yep, fine.
And Phil is from St. Basil's. Now, tell me a little bit about St. Basil's as a charity.
Hi. Well, St. Basil's worked with young people, 16 to 25-year-olds, both in Birmingham, but mainly for us over here, it's the Solihull district. We have a number of projects where young people can come. We can give them accommodation, we can give them life skills, we can train them to live independently. And the idea is that we get them into education, get them into work, and then move them on.
So how long has St. Basil's been going?
Many, many, many years.
More years than we care to remember.
Yeah, a lot of years. I can't remember the exact figure, got to be honest, but it's over 30.
And you're not here alone. Who else is here on your stand?
Well, there's myself who works for St. Basil's, and then we've got volunteers along running the store for us today.
So you've got lots of leaflets and information that's over there. If anyone wants to find out any more, they can do that. And of course, you're being supported by this event, aren't you?
Oh yes, they've been supporting us for quite a while now, and it's a blessing in disguise. It really is. They do a lot for us.
And if people want to find out more about St. Basil's, is there a website, phone number to get in touch with?
Yeah, if you go straight on, just Google St. Basil's and it all comes up. There's St. Basil's Solihull, St. Basil's Birmingham. If people want to have a look at what they can do for their youngsters or any youngsters they meet. Obviously, in the Solihull district, they have to have a local connection. Otherwise, we can't move them on unless we've got the council will accept that they can rehouse them once they're 18 and once they're ready. But we've got the same for Birmingham as well. We have St Basil's run the homeless hub in Solihull and in Birmingham. So people from the council who go to the council get referred to the hub. The hub then assesses them and distributes them to the most appropriate property.
Sounds like a fab service and absolutely critical for some of our young people. So thank you very much, Phil, for everything you're doing. If you want to come down and have a chat to us in the studios for a longer time, I'll give you a call. Is that all right?
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Phil. Thank you. Well, we are here. We've got Jeff and all the crew here down by the little dog area. We've also got some free sweeties. If you want to come and see us, if you'll come into the Fun in the Park, do come. It's a beautiful day. How are you doing, Jeff? You all right?
Yeah, not too bad. I'll be a bit disappointed if you don't come past and take either a sweet or a biscuit.
Otherwise, we're going to have to give it to our kids.
Yeah.
And they are going to be highest kites.
Well, they're hovering around them anyway.
Yeah, so do take it off our hands and have a chat. Let us know what you've been enjoying, what's your favourite stand, what you've been up to. If you've got a dog, it'd be lovely to meet them as well. Give them a little bit of a fuss. And generally have a great time.
The sun is also coming out.
That is always good news. It was raining this morning about 8 o'clock when we were setting up. And we were all going, ooh. But then just about 9:30, the sun came out from between a couple of clouds. And it's been glorious ever since.
That's right. Here's a little bit more music for you, and we'll be right back.
I'm going to have a little wonder and see what I can find. It's a beautiful day here at Shooter Grange Park. It is Fun in the Park. Use the hashtag Fun in the Park if you get the chance. The blue sky is out. Is it an Indian summer? Well, who knows? But we have. I'm watching the Bugs Group in action, putting the fun into fitness. We've got footy bugs, dance bugs. I think there might even be yoga bugs as well. And there is a lady here who's impressed me with her bag of Haribos. Well, yeah, if you're going to offer one. Thank you very much. And what's your name, I ask?
My name is Lisa. I'm here from the Bugs Group.
Okay, tell us a little bit more about the Bugs Group.
Okay, so we have yoga bugs, footy bugs, dance bugs and multi-bugs.
That's a lot of bugs.
That's a lot of bugs, and we're all about kids' fitness. We're all about making it fun and getting everybody involved.
So primarily, where do you work?
So for the football and the dance, we do community classes, but we also work in lots of schools and nurseries. And for the yoga, it's just schools and nurseries.
Okay, how long have you been going for?
The yoga bugs started about 15 years ago, footy bugs about 6 years ago, and the dance and multi-sports in the last couple of years.
Is this your baby? Did you start it?
I didn't start it, but I've been here for 9 years, and I am the general manager for the whole group. I'm really passionate about getting children active from a young age and making it fun for them.
So which one do you gravitate towards? Are you a footy person, a dance person, or what?
Yoga, definitely.
Right, so you're a very calm and chilled out person.
Yeah, well, we teach yoga bugs through story adventures, so we do get them really quite excited, but we like to start nice and calm and finish nice and calm.
So if there's anybody out there who's listening, a teacher or whatever, and you want in their school, how would they get in touch with you?
Absolutely, they can just go onto our main website, which is www.bugsgroup.com, or give us a call on 0121 777792.
Thank you very much, Lisa. I'll catch you again soon. Thank you. Well, lovely lady. Anyone who gives me a packet of Haribos is a winner as far as I'm concerned. Right, let's go for a wander out here. We've got some sand art. Let's have a little look down here. Ooh. Now, what we've got here is lots and lots of silver-type dishes, and I presume you make your own sand container with layers of sand. In fact, there's some people over here. Would you like to talk to me on Solihull Radio? No, not really. He's going, keep away from me. I'm working that out. I can read between the lines there. There we go. What else have we got here? We've got a stand all about suffrage. And there's a lady in here. There's some ladies in here. Would you like to talk live on Solihull Radio by any chance, ladies? Tell me about suffrage. They're saying, no way. That's terrible. Oh, my gosh. I'm going to have a little look here anyway. And, of course, it's 100 years of votes for the campaign for votes for women, 100 years of the suffragettes. And there's been a big campaign locally run by the Sir Optimus. And if you've been around on Whitney Manor Station, you'd have seen that there's a big display. That's right. Maybe I might be able to talk to the suffragette who's wandering around as we speak.
Suffragette that's wandering around
The only suffragette. If you see her, send her in my direction. Thank you very much. See you later. There we go. I'm lovely. Why don't people want to talk to me? Maybe I need to be a... There's a lady here. There's a woman who's waving. I do apologise. Would you like to talk on Solihull Radio? Well, first of all, what's your name and who are you representing?
My name's Maria Pulley and we're representing St Alfred's Rotary Club. We raise a lot of funds in the area and we're having a nice day.
So this morning, when you looked at the sky, were you a bit worried?
Well, we were worried yesterday because we're one of the organisers today and we were worried about the weather, but we looked at the forecast and decided that, you know, we were going to get up and have a go and the sun's come out. So.
What a good job you did, because it's glorious. I pulled up in my car with some of the stuff for Solihull Radio and we were just, it was just teeming down. And, wow. Tell us a few of the charities that you guys are supporting this year.
Well, we're supporting Marie Curie and the Lily May, and also polio, which we've done for years. So, yeah.
Well, I wish you all the best of luck. Hopefully you guys might want to come on Solihull Radio and tell us about how much you've raised. Thank you very much. Lovely to meet you. So there we go. What a lovely event. If you are listening at home, get in your car, get on your bike, get on the bus, get down here for the next couple of hours and have a great time. I'm just walking over here. There is a dog agility course where you can pay to come on, and there is a very obedient dog here, or maybe not so obedient, about to be tempted to do some jumping, climbing, slalom, all sorts. Not bad at all. Right, well, I think we're going to have some music on. But if you want to come for an interview, if you want to get on Solihull Radio, come down, pay us a visit, and get yourself some sweeties. And then you can visit us and be part of the show. But from us at Solihull Radio, let's play some music. So here we are on Solihull Radio. I'm going to make my way over to the Dogs Trust, see what's going on. We have had many an interview with Rachel here. She's currently busy there with some bags and some flags. And let's see what's going on. She's currently with some customers here. I'm just going to see what's going on. And her dog, is her assistant, is sitting at the back. And look at the nervousness that people have when they see me with my pink microphone. And well, I'm going to go and interview the dog. Hello. Hello. How are you today? Unsurprisingly, the dog is not talking to me. I don't know why, but I'm poised. So anyway, I'll come back in a minute and I'll say hello. There we go. What have we got here? We've got Rich's Pets. What have we got here? Some dog walking services. The perfect pet care. I see what they've done there. Can I say hi? Hello. Would you like to talk on Solihull Radio about your business? Tell us about Rich's Pets.
Hi. Well, basically, I offer a dog walking service. It can be a one-off dog walk or regular visits. I also do pop-in visits to look after any small animals you have, i.e. cats to rabbits.
Okay. And how? And where is that? Is that anywhere in Solihull or a particular part?
It's anywhere in Solihull. I've tried to cover anywhere all over Solihull.
Okay, and how long have you been going?
Just under 12 months now.
All right, so good luck on that one. Have you had a good day so far?
Yeah, it's not been too bad, yeah.
And have you got dogs yourself?
I have, yes. I have an 8-year-old Staffordshire Bull Terrier. I took out Birmingham Dogs Home about 2 years ago.
Okay, and good luck with it. How do we get in touch with you if we wanted you to take our dog for a walk?
Well, you can either look on Facebook or I have a website, richiespets.co.uk.
Thank you very much. Pleasure to meet you. Have a little listen on solihullradio.com, okay? So here we go. Right, I'm near the dog enclosure. We've got a big thumbs up from Jeff. We're having a great time here on Solihull Radio. And, oh, Alessandra is just running across. Hello. I thought she was going to talk to me there, and actually she was just walking past. Fancy that. So I think we're going to have some more music here. Thank you for tuning in to Solihull Radio. Hello there, this is Nick on Solihull Radio. I am joined by a genuine suffragette. I must say, Jan, you're looking very good for your age, because it's 100 years since the suffragettes were around. So tell us a little bit about yourself, first of all.
Hi, I'm Jan. I'm a Solihull Soroptimist. It's an international women's organisation focused on women and girls, and particularly on education, leadership, all the issues that are still current today. I'm here at Fun in the Park, and I'm dressed as a suffragette. And we, as a club, have been supporting the centenary of the 100 years since women got the vote.
And what sort of events have you been doing? What sort of how have you been raising that awareness around the area?
Can I pass over to my colleague here? The
events. She was never going to escape.
We had an equalities event at the Core Theatre. We had we were in Mel Square doing a voting poll: why women don't use their votes. We were at Solihull Library doing a poll of why women don't use their votes. And we were at Solihull College.
Sorry, well, what have you found out? Why do women generally not use their votes?
We haven't collated it yet.
Oh, right, OK. So watch that space. Have you got an inkling why that might be? Or would you not want to tempt fate?
Well, a lot of women have said on the doorsteps that they actually vote the way their husbands tell them to.
Seriously? Yeah. In 2018?
Yeah. Unfortunately, yes.
OK, so we've got to raise some awareness of that. Is that something that you're working to do?
Yes,
and in fact, on Friday, October the 19th, we are holding an event, a workshop at Solihull College. Yeah. So contact Solihull Radio. They'll be given information. And if you contact Solihull Soroptimist.
No problem. I'd love to find out. Keep in touch and tell us how you've been getting on. Thank you very much, and thank you. And good luck with the rest of today. Thank you. Well, that's it. We're going to have a bit more music now here on Solihull Radio, and we're going to carry on enjoying Fun in the Park.
I've been wanting to talk through that track for a long time, just to say hi, and we're back here at Fun in the Park. My name's Jeff O'Brien. And thank you very much for joining us here on Solihull Radio. If you have been listening to our feed from about 11 o'clock this morning, we are live in Tudor Grange. We are broadcasting from a field. So if you can imagine this, look who's just walked in. Our amazing Friday night presenter. John, how you been going? What's been going on out there? Has it been good out there? Who you been seeing?
I've been all the way around, actually. I've been talking to different people, quite a few of them I actually know, yeah. So that makes it a little bit easier. But yeah, it's a good event. It's a very good event.
It's quite well, it's a good turnout, really, considering the weather this morning.
I'm actually trying to get one or two people to come here and have a live interview. Unfortunately, a lot of people won't. They're coming to a studio when there's only, right, two or three of us.
That's right.
But when they go speak to lots and lots of people, they don't want to know.
Yeah. it's a big confidence thing. If you've just joined us, we are live from Tudor Grange Park. Debs Donnelly, our amazing Saturday evening presenter, is trying to give away biscuits and sweets. But people are actually really, really sort of reserved, aren't they? They're not.
Yeah. It's a very, very good event. Very good event. There's two lads from Saffa sort of looking at me now. Yeah. I'll tell you what, shall I go and have a chat?
Hold on a minute.
I'll be careful. I nearly fell over there.
Nearly fell over.
Right, let's go and have a chat with
go
the
and
guys.
Have a chat.
Can you still hear me?
Yeah.
You can hear me. Guys, I can see you looking here. Now you're live on Solihull Radio, yeah? So how's it going for you? What's the event like for you?
Fine. I mean, I've been static really on the stall all morning, so I haven't had a look around, but yeah. Get a break in a minute, I think, and have a wander around, have a look at what's going. But yeah, it's good. Apart from the weather.
Well, the weather looks like it's gonna carry on and gonna be a nice day. What about you then, sir? You're not a Brummie, are you?
No, London.
London. Whereabouts in London?
Wimbledon.
Wimbledon. Wimbledon. Do you hear that one, Jeff? He's at Wimbledon. He's come all the way from Wimbledon.
Wimbledon.
Sorry, say that again.
Come up for the day to help them out.
All right. So were you in the forces yourself, were you?
Yeah.
And if you don't mind me, if you don't mind me telling folks who obviously can't see you, so what's your name?
Tony.
Tony's sitting here in one of these motorised wheelchairs, and he gets around as best he can. He's been going around. Thank God it's not muddy, eh?
No, I've got new tyres, so it'll handle it.
New tyres. You put your slicks on today?
Oh, yeah. The best stuff, just for the show.
There you go, then. So, has it been successful for Suffer?
This show really is flying the flag and getting the name out there rather than collecting funds for Suffer. We do a number of shows around the country where it literally is just being there to be seen and to answer questions. And we do have lately where we do a lot of counselling for members of the forces who are going through a rough time, their other halves, their wives, daughters. It's just to let them know how to handle the person that might be having PTSD, etc. And it does help, but we're doing that a lot more now because a lot more guys are starting to suffer with it.
Yeah, it's one of those unforeseen things, isn't it? You know what I mean? People look okay on the outside, but it's what's happening inside that is the problem, isn't it? Tony, thank you very much for your time. Thank you very much for your time, guys. Speak to you soon.
Nice one, John. Thanks for getting out there. If you look directly behind us here, look, do you not think they're just hamster wheels for people to wander around and get blown about in the wind?
I think there's some big hamsters in there.
There are, look at that. I think a wind effect needs to be taken into consideration.
I think you're right, we don't want to be chasing those down the road.
If you're wondering what we're looking at, we're looking at the Zorb Zone here at Tudor Grange Park today. We are up on the cycle track area in central Solihull. If you want to come down and join us, why don't you? We're here till 5 o'clock when the event sort of finishes up, rolls to an end. So if the wind doesn't take away our gazebo again, as it did this morning, but why don't you come down? The rain is staying away for us today, which is brilliant. So hopefully you can join us. But here's a little bit more music for you. We'll be right back in a bit.
Here we are on Solihull Radio. My name is Nick Whitehouse, and we are walking and strolling across the grass, and I am aiming directly because there is nobody there to speak to. Birmingham Dogs Home. Can you talk to me now, please? I tried to speak to your dog earlier. She had nothing to say on the matter. How are you doing? It's Rachel. Well remembered. There we go. And how's it going today?
It's doing really well. I'm a little bit cold, I'm not going to lie. But
You see, I said to everybody when they texted me, is it cold? I said, it's a lovely day.
No, it's freezing. I'm freezing. It's a thing, but
all the women I've met to boat to, they've all said it's absolutely freezing. The mayor thought it was freezing.
Yeah, it's cold.
So what have you got here?
So we have got some of our merchandise. We haven't got our tombola today because that's ready and waiting for our open day on Sunnyside on the 20th of October. We've got some key rings, we've got travel mugs, we've got badges, notepads, training leads. And I'm just here for any information as well. So anyone's got any questions or want to talk about the dogs, come and see us.
So have you got any dogs who you really want to find a home for at the moment?
We've always got lots. We do have one called Chip, who's a Staffy, like a long-legged Staffy cross. Oh, and he's beautiful. He just needs a home that's a little bit more active, older children. So if anyone's interested in Chip, take a look on our website. And there will be a video next week of him as well on the social media.
Some of your dogs aren't online, is that right? You need to actually come to the centre and see some of them.
Definitely. We always suggest making sure you come down because legally they're not ours until day 8, so we can't put them on the website. So if you want to have first pickings, make sure you come down, speak to our team, or give us a call as well.
So if people want to find out more, what is your website?
It's www.birminghamdogshome.org.uk.
Brilliant. Tell me more about your event. It was originally scheduled in July, is that right? And you've had to move it due to dodgy weather?
Yes, so it was in August. Sadly, they had an outbreak of parvo as well around the area. Right. So just to make sure that our dogs are safe and those of our visitors, we did postpone it until 20th of October, okay. Which means it's going to be very cold. But we've done all that hard work and our supporters love it. So we just made sure it still does go ahead.
So what sort of things are going to be going on there?
we've got a fun dog show. We've got stalls, we've got refreshments, barbecue, tombola, free children's play area. It really is a good fun day out for all the family.
Have you got space for a small gazebo with a Solihull radio team in it?
We could well have, yeah, but it's over in Wolverhampton.
I don't know. I'll speak to the powers that be. We are internet-based. People like dogs around Solihull, and I guess they'll be interested to find out.
Yeah, no, definitely. We've also got our Santa Paws event, which is very, very popular.
Santa Paws, yeah. Christmas!
We're talking Christmas already!
So what's happening there?
So, it's basically, you can bring your dog, and they can see Santa for £10. You get a free digital photograph sent to you via email after the event. And you can get some mince pies for you and your dog, get some hot drinks. We've also got a caricature going. So Cartoon Rich, who can do a caricature for just £10 of your dog as well, which are absolutely brilliant. He does it right in front of you. So yeah, it's a nice event. You can come down, pop in, say hello, get your photograph, and then leave within, you know, an hour or so.
I know a black Labrador puppy who might really like that.
Yeah, no, definitely come down. It's a nice, fun feel event. You know, we're all dressed up like elves and the Santa's there. So, yeah.
So if nobody's been there before, whereabouts are you located in Solihull?
So we're in Catherine de Barnes, Solihull, near the boat. It's, you know, we've got fantastic facilities, 12 and a half acres of land, and the dogs are very pampered with their underfloor heating. So they, unlike me today, I'm cold, they'll be very nice and toasty. So I'm a bit envious of the dogs in our centre today.
I love it. Thank you very much for talking to us. Stay in touch. Thanks ever so much. Well, do come down here towards the end of the day, and because it's a beautiful day. We were a bit worried about the sunshine and the showers earlier on, but no. The sun has burned through the clouds, and it's beautiful. Let's see if there's anybody else here who wants to talk to Solihull Radio. I'm going to see if I can find another interview, but for now, we're going to have some more music cued in by the lovely Debs Donnelly. Good afternoon, it's me, Nick Whitehouse, here live on Solihull Radio. I'm here in Fun in the Park, and I'm joined by three lovely young ladies. Who have we got?
I'm Amber.
And?
Jenny.
And?
Becky.
And how long have you been here? You've been just arrived, or you've been here a little while?
Well, me and Jenny have been here for about an hour. Becky came like half an hour ago.
Okay, what's the best thing so far? Apart from Solihull Radio, of course.
Dogs.
Dogs. There are lots of dogs. And we have a dog here with us. And what is the dog's name?
Chloe.
And has Chloe won a prize? There is a rosette.
Yeah, she won just for, like, the being good.
Just for being well-behaved. Is there... All right, Debs. Thank you very much. What breed is Chloe?
She's a French bulldog.
A French bulldog. Debbie, did you think that was a French bulldog?
I do think it was a French bulldog.
Look at that. She's so clever. And what are you going to see next?
I don't actually know.
You're just going to take it as it comes. Okay. Well, I hope you have a great day. Thank you very much. Have a little listen to Solihull Radio later. Thank you very much. Bye for now.
Nice colour. Hi there, everybody. This is Reeves here. Just to let you know that we are in the park, Fun in the Park, and it's going really, really well. It's a really nice day. There's lots and lots of people here. It is a little bit breezy, but apart from that, it's quite a nice day. We've done some good interviews today as well. The marvellous Debbie's just walking back towards me at the moment.
Oh, hello.
Oh, hello. I'm on air, Debs. I just thought I'd let you know I'm on air, so you're not swearing or anything like that.
We are live on air. Do not swear.
What has been your best bit?
What are my best bits? Actually, the chocolate.
I've got to tell you, folks, Debs is going on this...
I'm quite excited because down the bottom of the hill, there is a bus with a mini on it. And the guy who owns the bus said he's 99% sure that is the original one from the Italian Job film.
Really?
It's got the same number plate and the fixes. But because they haven't got the provenance, they can't prove it.
Oh, nice story,
so
that, though, isn't it?
Favourite bit.
That's your favourite bit, is it? Oh, wonderful, wonderful.
Love that film.
Off that film? Yes. Where? It's all right, folks. I'm waiting for Jeff to get back with the music. I'm just going to have to... Emily, let's have a chat with you.
How are you doing?
Right.
How are you doing today?
Yeah, I'm good, thank you. So, Tell me what, tell the viewers, the listeners, what your role is with Solihull Radio.
So my role is, lovely listeners of Solihull Radio, I am the social media manager for Solihull Radio. So I do all of the output on Facebook, on Twitter, some of the Instagram things as well. And yeah, just making sure that people know who we are, because it's such a big part of what we do, is just getting the word out there and spreading it out to everyone. Yeah, and then last week I made a starring role on Matt's show on Thursday at 6 p.m. last Thursday, which has been fantastic as well. So yeah, it's been good.
So you're the brains of the operation, basically.
Essentially, that's what I'm saying. Yes, yes, yes. It was all my idea. It's all me. It's all me. Solihull Radio, essentially. What about you? Do a bit of a plug for your show, maybe. What a great idea.
Yeah. Well, yeah. I mean, I could do with it, to be honest. Now, my show apparently is going quite well. People keep telling me, hold on, turn around, we're having our picture took. Look. We're live on air. We're live on air, we're having our photograph taken. Wonderful. Thank you. Yeah, my show's going quite well. What I try and do with my show is that it is essentially Solihull. So I don't do things like with neighbouring Birmingham and things like that, if I can help it. I cover Solihull Moors Football Club because I'm involved there. Yeah. But everything I do is Solihull. And on next Friday night, I have a crime prevention show.
Oh, okay.
Well, the nights are drawing in now, you see. So I thought, well, with the nights drawing in, you know, people get a little bit uptight, shall we say. Things go missing, all that kind of thing. So I thought, I've got a friend who's an ex-policeman who runs his own security company, so he's going to come in and have a chat with us and tell us what to do, the right things to do, the wrong things to do. So it'll be an interesting show.
Amazing. And what's your background? How did you get involved in Solihull Radio?
Well, that's a good one. My background, I used to be in the Royal Navy, and then I used to do a little bit of a radio show on board the ship. Because we had our own radio shack, as it happens. And it was all vinyls in those days. There was none of this DVDs and stuff like that. Certainly no internet or anything. And basically, that's how I got involved with it. And then I saw Jeff. And we got chatting. And he said, why don't you come and have a chat? Did do. Next thing I know, I'm on it.
The rest is history. Wow. Yeah. What a backstory. What a backstory. How about you, Debs? How did you get involved in Solihull Radio?
Deb's at the moment, folks. She's going on this fitness craze, but she's stuffing her face with chocolate. This is why she can't talk.
Right, because I live on my own. I'm lying in bed bored. This is the story. And I went through Facebook, and then Nick's face came up and said, excuse me, do you fancy being a local radio personality? So I just literally left the message, me. Next thing I know, I get a personal message back saying, send us your details, whatever, and then I never heard anything. My daughter said, there's 0% mother that you're going to get an interview for a radio show. I went, okay, I know. I said, but unless I try, I don't know. About 4 weeks later, I had a phone call from Nick, will you come for an interview? I went for the interview. Well, I didn't actually get interviewed. I interviewed them. And
that's typical of you.
And about 20.
You're such a quiet wallflower, Debs. Yeah, you're so quiet. I don't think I've ever heard you say a word. This is the most I've ever heard you speak.
And then 20 minutes later, they said 6 till 8 on a Saturday. Well, actually, it was 7 till 9 then. 7 till 9 on a Saturday night. And I went, fantastic. They said, you've got the job. And that was it. And I've been with them ever since.
And that was it. And you've been with them ever since? Wow. Exactly. You can carry on now and eat your chocolate now. Yeah, yeah. I don't know where Jeff has disappeared to with our music. Oh, well, I think we're just trying to get some music sorted. You must realise, folks, that we're doing an outside broadcast, and sometimes these things are not quite working as we want to. But I think Emily sorted it now, so here we go.
Good afternoon, ladies and gents. My name is Jeff O'Brien. We are live at Tudor Grange Park in Solihull. So if you want to come down and join us now, it is looking busier. There are people all around us here, and people enjoying pizzas, street food. And they're just doing the sit challenge for the dog show that's directly in front of us. Who's coming in now? Hi, what's your name? Where'd you come from? No, couldn't quite manage that, could you? Couldn't quite manage that question. That stumped you. Sorry about that. Maybe we'll ask somebody else. we got there in the end. Look, come down and join us. We are live here in Tudor Grange. We're broadcasting from a field. So hopefully music is all lined up, playing and enjoying itself. So let's go. We'll be right back after a bit of this.
I'm on air now. Oh, I'm on air. I've just got the thumbs up there. There. I'm now, as you know, we're out at the Fun in the Park, and I'm now at the Social Inclusion stand. And I'm the quick signpost inclusion. I've said the wrong one. Sorry, folks. Now, let's have a chat with Vicky. What's your role, Vicky?
I run signpost inclusion.
So you're the main woman?
The main one, yeah. We've got we're running a really, really small team, so there's not many of us anyway, but we all work really, really hard.
And they do, actually, yeah, they do. They work very, very hard. So tell us a bit more about your organisation then.
Right, we run an organisation that supports families that have got children with additional needs. We run lots of activities, fun activities for children with additional needs and also with their families. We just have lots and lots of fun, basically. We try skiing, canoeing, archery. We have youth clubs. There's lots and lots of things, dancing, singing. It goes on and on.
I've got to say, folks, I do help out. I do quiz nights for them and we have a great time. So how long have you been doing this then?
Oh, about 5 years. I started off as a volunteer initially, and then it's just sort of gone from strength to strength. There's lots and lots of families that kind of need support, and we're kind of there, and we're family-led and young people-led, so we go whatever's needed in Solihull.
Well, that's brilliant. And Debbie's disappeared now. She was actually doing... she was having a go with the crossbow event here, but I think she's gone now. Yeah, she's run off now. She's run off and left me on my own. She took your bow as well. She's took the bow as well. Well, listen, has it gone well for you today?
It has. It was a bit slow to start off with, but, you know, I went up there and had a little chat, and then we had a bit of surge of adults and kids. So, yeah, it's picking up now. We're doing quite well.
Brilliant. I think I better go back to Jeff now, because it's getting a bit noisy around here. Thank you, Vicky.
If you are listening to the output here at Solihull Radio, we are currently broadcasting from Tudor Grange Park. Hopefully you've been enjoying some of the afternoon's broadcast today. We're going to finish off in about 25 minutes or so, because Lee is busily getting ready for her show. 4 o'clock at the Touchwood studio. So she's getting everything sorted out. She's got some fantastic guests and amazing music lined up for you today. If you have been down to Tudor Grange Park today, well done, everybody. The weather has held. It's been a bit windy, obviously, but the rain has held off for us today, so we don't have to worry too much about that. Have you had a good time?
I've had a fantastic time.
Enough said. Have you had a good time?
Oh, I've had a good time, yes.
There you go, you see. And if you want to see Solihull Radio broadcasting live from your event, why don't you get in touch with us? studio@solihullradio.com. Why don't you just get in touch and say, we've got an event. We wouldn't mind having this broadcast live from our event. We can come to you now, wherever you are. And hopefully you've enjoyed the output today. We're going to leave you with a little bit of music just to finish off with this afternoon. And then once we get everything sorted here, we're going to go and enjoy ourselves and have some fun. So here we go. Here's a little bit of music for you just to take you up towards the end of us today into Lee's show live from the Touchwood studio. Feel the pull.
long afloat on shipless oceans. I did all my best to smile till your singing eyes and fingers drew me loving to your isle, and you sang, sail to me, sail to me, let me enfold you. Here I am, here I am, waiting to hold you. Did I dream you dreamed about me? Were you here when I was fighting? But now my foolish boat is leaning, broken love long on your rocks now. Before you sing, touch me not, touch me not, come back tomorrow. Oh my heart, oh my heart, shies from the sorrow. I'm as puzzled as the newborn child. I'm as riddled as the tide. Should I stand amid the breakers, or should I lie with death my bride? Oh, hear me sing, swim to me, swim to me, let me enfold you. Here I am, here I am, waiting to hold you.
Years ago, my heart was set to live. Oh, I've been trying hard against unbelievable odds. It gets so hard in times like now to hold on, but guns lit way to be stuck by at my side is God. Turn me around.
trying hard against strong odds. It gets so hard in times like now to hold on. Will I fall if I don't fight? At my side is God. And there ain't no one going to turn me around. Ain't no one going to turn.
This is Deb Sonnelly inside a big rubber ball, the first ever outside broadcast of Solihull Radio to Dean Isorby. I've lost total control. I can't do this anymore. Really sick. I've got to get up.
This brings us to the end of our live broadcast from Fun in the Park for this year. Join us again next year, hopefully, with from the Fun in the Park. Oh, hold on a second. What's up? Right. Well, that brings to the close today of our live broadcast. It's exactly 3:30. In about half an hour's time, why don't you join Lee over at the Touchwood studio? And then once everything kicks off from the Touchwood studio at 4 o'clock, rather, right through till 6 o'clock. We hope you've enjoyed listening in to what's been happening in Tudor Grange Park. Thank you very much if you have joined us today, and we'll see you again very soon. Bye-bye for now from Fun in the Park 2018. Bye.